Hey everyone, how's it going? It's me, it's Korzak. Welcome back to part 2 of the Dark Cloud 2 walkthrough. So, we are going to be starting off with the basics. So, you may see this information here. It says time limit to defeat all monsters, 2 minutes and 35 seconds. If you do that, you get a medal. Then there's an unknown, which we will unlock about halfway through the game. And then clear all without healing. This basically means do the entire floor without using any healing items, and you'll get a medal. Medals are used for purchasing cosmetic gear and getting something called a name change ticket, which you can use as a glitch to actually get you like a super high-end weapon much earlier than usually possible, or usually feasible, I should say. So let's get right into it. There's also an achievement for collecting every medal in the entire game, which we will cover how to do, but a little bit later.
Wow.
Thanks, Komian. Piles everything.
It's like a maze. Could get lost pretty easy here.
Okay, then you need to get the floor map. It should be in one of the treasure chests on that floor. Will show you where you are on a particular floor. Shouldn't get lost if you have one. If you don't want the map in the way, you can turn it off and on with the select button. All right, in order to get to the next floor, you need the gate key. I think the one in the channel's called the key handle. If you use the gate key on the exit for that floor, you can get to the next floor. Just keep doing that and you can get to the end of any dungeon. Got it, Max?
Roger, Donnie. I'll give it a try.
Cool. So I'm pretty much going to go over everything that was just said in that dialogue. So, first let's check out all the options that we have available to us. So, most of these I don't really ever use, but you can have vibration on or off. I'm going to turn it off personally. You can have your message speed, basically just how fast, not like spoken dialogue, but unspoken dialogue. That'll just kind of make that go slower or faster, however you wish. And you can change how your sound is displayed. You can change how fast time changes in this game. I just leave this at normal until later on in the game, and I'll point it out again when we get to that point. So map display, you can pick 1, 2, or 3. So that's basically just... So this is 1, where you have nothing. This is 2, where it's a small map. And this is 3, where it covers pretty much your whole screen, but it has the entire map available to you. You can have the enemy's HP display. I recommend you keep this on. I recommend you keep the anger counter on. If you hit an enemy a certain amount of times, then they have a little red bar above their HP. I'll show you guys soon. And if that gets to 0, they become enraged and start doing big damage if they hit you. And the rest of this, we don't really have to worry about. Alright, so we got a sewer rat here. You see those little red things above the yellow bar? Okay, so every time you hit him, he loses one of those little red things. And if he gets down to 0, he'll become angry. He'll kind of go into an attack power up stance, and he will do damage to you. So you can lift these crates up by holding down R1, which is also how you block in this game. You can do this and then press X to pick things up. You can pick up certain monsters too. And if you pick up these crates, there may be treasure in some of them. Like, usually it might just be like an antidote or a piece of bread or something, or just little useful things. So it is worth doing it. As long as you aren't on a floor that you're trying to get a medal for that asks you to specifically only attack enemies with your right-hand weapon. Because picking things up and throwing them can actually deal damage, too. Like, you can pick these crates up, throw them at an enemy, and it deals damage. The problem with that is if you have a metal that says only use your wrench and you pick up a crate and throw it, you're not going to get that metal anymore, unfortunately. I think it's a glitch, but it's just kind of how things are set up. So every map has a gate key, which will drop from an enemy, which you can then use to move on. There are also chests, which will give you various rewards. There's a map on every floor, and there's a compass on every floor. Or not a compass, it's called something else, but I'll show you guys when we get it. We're actually getting really lucky with the crystals. But anyway, here's a map. So now you'll see that the entire map is on display, and it's all grayed out. So basically, it kind of shows us where we still need to go and explore. So it's a nice, convenient thing to have. I do really love this game, but the mini-map thing is kind of clunky, because if you have it big, which you usually want to so you can see where you're going, it kind of covers up a big portion of the screen, which kind of sucks. But unfortunately, it is what it is. I can look past it. Okay, yeah, see, we can pick up enemies after they're knocked down. So if you take an enemy out by, like, throwing something at them, look at my weapons. I just got experience for both. Same thing if you defeat an enemy with an item. It'll then be evenly distributed across both of your weapons. And there's two characters in this game. We'll go over that in a sec. And if you take an enemy out with Max and then swap over to Monica, she'll get the experience points evenly split across both of her weapons. Got some bread, nice. So, you may have noticed that my wrench got a level up. So, now it says Battle Wrench +1. Before, it would have just said Battle Wrench. If you look at my gun, it says Classic Gun. When the blue bar becomes full, it will then be Classic Gun +1. And you'll gain synthesis points. Right now, I just have one. On my wrench, I either had 1 or 0, but now I have 4. So if you go into this menu here, like you can press X on it and go to build up. So now there's two options. One needs attack, smash, and beast, and one just needs attack. So if we can get enough stuff into it, we'll then be able to build up the weapon to make it even more powerful. So the way this works is you can actually break down literally everything. Like, I can break down this bread by going to Spectrumize, and it highlights what it'll actually give me. So I can break down bread, put it on my weapon to make it more powerful, which is funny. We can do it to sugar cane, to our antidote, to our water even, or even this. Literally everything. I never really worry too much about durability, honestly. It's kind of like the last thing I would upgrade, honestly. Because just kind of playing through the game, it'll naturally level up when you build your weapons up anyway. It's not really too big of a deal, in my opinion. So, if we spectrumize a crystal, it'll give us one extra point per level. So it's always best to use crystals to increase your stats if you can. So we're gonna use 3 to increase the smash on our wrench. So now we only have 1 synthesis point left. Cool. So now you notice how smash isn't highlighted anymore for the weapon upgrade. We no longer need smash. So basically now we just have to worry about beast and attack. You gain attack every single time your weapon gets a +1 level. So sometimes you can just level it up and you'll kind of get it over time, but other things you have to use crystals to increase the stats. Here's another example. I'm going to spectrumize 2 crystals. I only have 1 synthesis point on my weapon, so now it doesn't work. So I'm going to have to wait until I level the wrench up again before I can put these flame crystals on there. It's a lot of information, but once you get used to it, it becomes pretty easy. I also recommend trying to level your weapons up kinda one level for one level. Like, I got my wrench a level, now I should get my gun a level. And when I get my gun a level, I should try and get my wrench another level. I just feel like it keeps your character evenly strong. And there's some enemies that you're going to have an advantage against. That's the key handle. So that's the gate key that we need to actually leave this place. So one random enemy in the dungeon will always have this. As we were saying, some enemies are weak against the gun, and some enemies are weak against the wrench. So that frog that we threw a crate at a minute ago, it's actually a lot easier if you just take them out with your wrench. But because he was stunned, he wasn't going to be jumping around or anything, so I had no problem taking him out with the gun. Cool. So, my weapon's broken now. This means that it will no longer be effective. So in this game, if your weapon breaks, you just can't use it until you use repair powder, and it'll work again. In Dark Cloud 1, your weapon would completely disappear. Yeah, it would just disappear, which happened to me sometimes in playthroughs, and that really sucked. So yes, it's a lot easier in this game. In fact, honestly, ideally, I would recommend you just let your weapons break in Dark Cloud 2 only before you use the weapon up, the weapon repair powder. Just because your weapon will never disappear if it breaks, and you have real no penalty if your weapon breaks in this game. So this way you're just kind of getting the most bang for your buck with every powder that you use. It's a little bit more... it's a little harder to get these things early game. Later on it's not a big deal really, but early game I would recommend you just kind of get every point out of it that you can use. Alrighty, and here's the compass I was talking about. It's actually just called the magic crystal. So now I can see where everything, it's not a good example now because I'm in this area so I can see them, but say I was on the other side of the map where that little green square is at the start. If I walked in and got the compass there, I would now be able to see all the little red and yellow dots across the entire map. That's what the magic thing will tell, that's what the magic crystal will do for you. It tells you where everything is. Yeah, so these guys will actually poison you. So these guys are kind of crappy to be up against because they can actually... they're the first enemy that'll deal damage to you when you're blocking.
All right. That takes care of you guys.
So once you beat all the enemies on a floor, Max or Monica will do that little dance and have that animation to just kind of let you know that you're done. So poison will never kill you in this game, and explosions will never kill you in this game. It'll just take you down to 1 HP. When I say explosions, I mean explosions from booby-trapped chests, which we will find later in the playthrough. And I'll make sure to point it out again at that point. Obviously, if there's an enemy who uses explosions as damage, they'll take your character out. So I'm not going to heal until we leave this place, so that we can get the metal for the floor. Boom, right there. Cleared, finished without healing. Goal. You got a medal.
I pressed on, deeper into the underground channel. I had said I want to see the outside world to Donnie, but there was a second reason why I wanted to go there.
Your flounder, sir. Bon appétit.
Max, where are your manners? Eat your dinner.
Father? I'd like to ask you something.
Yes? What is it?
About Mother. Where is she?
I'm sure I told you this already. Your mother is doing important work far away from here.
But what's the name of the town, and what job is she doing there?
It's nothing for you to worry about. Eat your dinner.
This is just how you always are. You don't tell me anything.
Young sir, would you like me to go after him, sir?
Leave him be.
Max is kind of a spaz, actually, in the early parts of the game, but I think he has a lot of character growth later on. I'm gonna make an extra save, just in case. How many save slots do we have access to, actually? I've never actually really looked. 13, okay. That's more than enough for sure. Battle with the rats. By the way, don't even bother trying for the time challenge right now. 2 minutes and 40 seconds to complete this is not an easy thing to do. Just come back later when we're significantly overpowered and we can just wipe every floor out in like a minute. And the experience isn't really necessary at that point, so skipping everything's not a big deal. Because in order to actually beat the time challenge, you literally have to not pick up the experience points from every enemy. I'm going to try and use my gun a lot more on this level, because the next floor has a medal for only using your right-hand weapon. So our gun is a lot stronger against these balloons, and we're also going to encounter bats. If it's not in this level, it'll be in the next level. The gun's good against the bats as well, and then our wrench is pretty much good against everything else in here. So I'll show you guys why it's usually better. Like this guy, yeah, he jumps and he'll dodge my bullets sometimes. You have to time it perfectly, or you won't hit him. So it's usually easier to just use your wrench on the frogs. But if once you get the timing down, you can use your gun as well. Although if you want to secure it, then you can just stun the guy by throwing a crate or another enemy at him. Got the crystal. So yeah, here's a better example. Now we can see the dots everywhere. These wooden crates are not on display. They're just kind of randomly placed throughout the map, but it's not the kind of thing that's really on the minimap. So, this is awesome. So when you get these, no matter what, always pick explosion. Always. Always pick explosion. The reason for this is if you don't pick explosion, and it ends up being explosion, the chest will blow up. It'll just be gone, you'll lose whatever item was in there. And usually booby-trapped chests have good items, like holy crystals right here. But sometimes you can get some really rare items, which will definitely help you out. I definitely think it's worth using the two items to repair your gear, or the two items to unpoison yourself and heal yourself up after. I think it's definitely worth it. So always pick explosions so you never lose the loot that's in the chest. Okay, so here's another example. We don't have the key right now, but you can get some treasure chest keys, and that's literally what it's called, from what I remember. And you can use that, or you can try forcing it if you don't have it. Okay, so right there. All you can really do is try and force it if you don't have a key, and it can be the same thing as the other one. It'll poison you, or destroy your weapons, or be an explosion. So the good thing about an explosion is it'll never kill you. it'll just deal decent damage, and the chest will, it'll, well, the chest will be gone, so you'll no longer have access to whatever item was in there, unfortunately. And poison will also never kill you, as we said before. So this game is, I don't want to say easy, because there are actually some pretty challenging bits in this game, but it is a little more, it's a little bit more forgiving than Dark Cloud 1. I was never the biggest fan of Dark Cloud 1, honestly. Like, I've beaten the game maybe 4 or 5 times. I've beaten this game like a dozen times. Like, I'll play Dark Cloud 1 for maybe every 3 or 4 times I play Dark Cloud 2. I think I play Dark Cloud 2 once every year and a half, maybe, on average. But Dark Cloud 1, it's not voice acted, which is fine. I mean, I like a lot of non-voice acted games. But I found Dark Cloud 1 to be very gritty, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. But I just kind of got depressed from playing that one. I just enjoy the art style in Dark Cloud 2 much more than the first one. We got a lot of these crates here, actually. So, like, you can kind of look at everything much nicer without the mini-map, but now I have no idea where I'm going, unfortunately. So I always play with the mini-map as big as possible, because then I can kind of see everything.
All right. That takes care of you guys.
You get used to needing to look through it, but I feel like they could have probably done a little bit of a better job with it. I would say the mini-map thing is probably my only complaint with this game. It's the only thing I can think of right now. After we're done the full walkthrough of this game, I've been kind of liking what I do. I play through a whole game and then I review it after. I mean, obviously I like this game or I wouldn't have played it as much as I have. But no game is perfect. But I still love this game. Alrighty, time for another save. So we're gonna try and only use our right-hand weapon in this level so that we can get a medal.
The underground channel ran on ahead in front of me. And as I pressed on, heading deeper, for some reason, thoughts of you, Mother, filled my head. I don't remember your face now, Mother, even though I must have seen it so often when I was small.
This loading screen right here, on the PS2, you would just kind of hope that the game actually bothered to load here, because sometimes it would just go on forever and you'd have to restart your PS2, you'd have to clean the disc, and then hopefully it would work next time.
How's it going? Made any progress?
Yeah, looks like I made it to the next floor.
Stronger the monsters are. Watch out.
I will.
To defeat the stronger monsters, you'll need to strengthen your weapons. If you don't take care of your weapons, you'll run into trouble on the next floor. If you want to know more about combat, give me a buzz. I'll help you out whenever you want. Select help from the main menu and choose what you want to know about from the list. You're a great fighter, so you'll pick up on it in no time.
Yeah, I'll do my best.
Okay, be careful.
Alrighty, so I'm going to say this right now. You can aim your weapon. That's fine. You can aim your weapon and you'll get the medal. But if I shoot this, even if I don't hit anything, I will not. I'm not going to get the medal anymore. So don't pick up a single crate, or you will not get the medal. Don't pick up a single enemy, or you will not get a medal. You have to literally just only attack everything by hitting X. It's kinda lame, but it's just how it is. You can heal, that's fine, no problem. But every single attack that comes out of you has to be a wrench attack. And that's it. Nothing else is okay. If you really wanted to, after you beat the level, you can kind of rerun through this place and then destroy the crates, because you get the medal after you take out the last monster. So whatever you want to do, just don't pick up an enemy, and don't deal any damage with anything other than your normal weapon. And do not ever fire your other weapon. And then if this was for the same thing but with my left-hand weapon, which is Max's gun, do not use your wrench at all. Do not swing your wrench. You can block, that's fine, but do not swing your wrench or it will not work. It kind of sucks. But that's just how the rules are in their code for this game. Yeah, the wrench is ready to level up now. So, I'm going to show you guys a little trick now. I'm going to put all of this beast onto my wrench. Okay, so awesome. We have enough beast for our weapon. We need more attack. So, let's pretend that we had enough attack here, okay? Let's just say we had enough to pick either upgrade. The one up here is Drill Wrench. The one down here is True Battle Wrench. Always pick the True Battle Wrench first. Always go the True Battle Wrench route first. Because you can then automatically go to the Drill Wrench after, and this will give you extra attack. So you'll get one extra point of attack on your weapon. It's only 1 point, but it's every little bit helps, right? So I'm actually not going to do that yet, because since my weapon is now refreshed, it's going to level up a lot quicker and easier. It doesn't require as much ABS, but it's called ABS, but it's just the experience point system in this game. So now I'm going to level this wrench up to level 3. Before I level it up to the battle wrench again, or to the drill wrench, sorry, because it's going to be significantly easier to level up a wrench that's at level 0. So this is just a very quick way of getting the maximum amount of synthesis points as fast as possible early game. This is like some really mid-maxing stuff. That's a good thing to have right now. So basically, we can destroy this for attack points to add to our weapon. So that's a good crystal to get. We're lucky. So as I was saying, it's some really mid-maxing stuff that I'm talking about right now. And you definitely don't have to do it. But it is a little trick that makes things a lot easier. And it just gets you more bang for your buck, I guess. By the way, with the previous floor, or two floors ago, when we had the medal for clear all without healing, if the first enemy we took out had the gate key, we could literally take the gate key, run over to the exit, leave, and then just be on our way and we get the medal. But with this medal, we have to physically take out every single enemy with our right-hand weapon before we can leave. So there's some nuances with every medal. Some of them are very, cheesable, I guess. And some of them are very specific, and it has to be done just like that. I think I have the gate key right now, yes? Yeah. So if I just left, I would not have I wouldn't receive the medal for taking everything out with my right hand weapon. I have to actually just take out every single enemy. Oh man, there's like literally one enemy all the way at the end in the corner, isn't there? That's just how some of these maps are made sometimes. These are randomly generated maps, so it is what it is. These turtles are very unpredictable enemies. Alright, come at me. Boom. So if you hold down X, you can do a charge attack, which kind of does more damage, but it'll also knock certain enemies down, or kind of daze them so that they cancel their attack animation. Sweet. Does his little dance. And there is our medal. Cool. So now we can do whatever we want. We have the medal, so we could do this if we want to. We can pick things up. We can destroy those crates, no problem. Cool. So we're gonna save on up. I'm gonna do an extra save again here. Alright, so this one's different. As you'll see, there's no window like this. Now it just says go to the channel pump room. So usually when that happens, there's some kind of little scene here, or just something about it's different than the other mission levels.
Chamber. There are what look like tanks everywhere.
Ah, that'll be the pump room. The pumps in there are used to draw water from the lake on the outside. You're not far from the outside now.
Gotcha. Thanks, Donnie. I gotta keep going.
Way through the sewers, you know. By the way, Max, I took the liberty of doing a little research on you. For someone like you, living in a big house with no wants and needs, don't you think it would be a waste if you threw your life away fighting us? And how sad indeed would your dear sweet mother be?
What? What do you know about my mother?
What if I did know something? If you want to know more, give me that red stone. I've got plenty to tell you. Well,
No way. I'll find my mother myself. I don't need help from anyone like you.
Ah, you stinking brat! You will regret this, I guarantee! Take care of them, my darling Linda.
So you can't win this fight. You can't do any damage to him. So what I do, I just like to run him kind of over here. And then I just run all the way over here. All the way to the door, and then I just kind of hang out. And usually by the time it gets decently close to me, it'll just kind of end automatically. There we go.
It's no good. I'll never win like this.
Now then, Max, what will it be?
Uh-oh. Huh?
What? Max, you all right? It's me.
Cedric, you finally completed the ride pod.
Yep, I named it Steve. I'm still working out the bugs, but it's got plenty of punch. Well, did you learn your lesson or what?
That's amazing, Cedric.
My sweet Linda couldn't compete with this one.
Using a resurrection powder.
Oh, we got an ornery son of a gun here. Come back for more, huh? Take that. Huh? What the?
Well, what's wrong?
Actually, I didn't finish that energy backpack yet. I don't think she can handle any more fighting for now. Hop in, Max.
Get on? But it can't move.
Don't you worry about that. There's enough juice to get us back. Come on, get in.
Running away, eh? Linda, get them!
Adios!
Oh my, they've run off!
But poor sports! Morning, Sonny. Sleep well?
Yeah. Tell me, Cedric, why do you think those circus goons are after this pendant of mine?
Who knows, kid? But if what you overheard in that room at the circus is true, then Mayor Need definitely knows something. I'll talk to Need and see if I can get anything out of him. Just don't let that pendant fall into their hands, no matter what.
I know. I won't give this up.
Alrighty then. This thing here is the problem. We gotta finish this up and take care of that pesky elephant.
All you need is an energy pack, right?
Yep.
Well, Cedric, how about letting me handle that?
You telling me that you wanna make the energy pack for Steve?
Yeah. I want to give it a try.
Alrighty then. The job's yours.
Alright!
You know, inventing stuff is pretty tough work. I'll show you how, Sonny, so you listen carefully.
Okay.
Inventing something involves taking several ideas and combining them together to create something new.
And ideas are, well, the building blocks for inventions. By combining the ideas inside your head, you can invent brand new stuff. Now here's some hints on making an energy pack for Steve. A milk can, pipes, and a belt. Now this is where things get tricky, see? Next, you gotta do some collecting. Here, use this camera. You can use it to capture stuff. First, press the square button to ready the camera. Then you can capture whatever you see in the viewfinder. Use the left analog stick to control the direction. And to take a picture, just press the square button again. Pretty simple, huh? Now you better go take some pictures. You need to look for a milk can, pipes, and a belt. You should be able to find them all within a couple hundred feet of here. You ready, Max? You're on your own now. Go get them.
All right, so before you can actually use the thing, you gotta equip it. And now whenever you press square, you can take pictures. So we are going to leave it here for this episode. We'll go over how to invent and how to pictures work in the next episode. So we're just going to go outside and save. So I'd like to thank you all for watching. I hope you have a good day, and we'll see you soon. Bye.